Finally, mga kasambahay, matapos ang halos isang taon na virtual dive escapade natin dahil sa lockdown at travel restrictions, nagbabalik naman tayo ngayon sa Anilao, Batangas para sa ating first diving adventure ngayong 2021. Hindi lamang basta new normal dive ang gagawin natin because we will guide you to the underwater paradise of Anilao kasama ang world-renowned Pinoy underwater photographer na si Ram Yoro. So gear up, buddies, and join us in making waves beneath. I am Cindy Maduma, and this is The Dive! Come and join our journey down into the reefs and tides. Come and sink beneath the waves, the wonders of this life. Open your eyes and see the world below the seas. It's the wonder of God's creation that makes us believe. You are the dive.
Isang Manila-based beachgoer o scuba diver ang tatanungin mo kung saan magandang pumunta para sa isang underwater escapade tulad ng snorkeling, free diving o scuba diving, siguradong Anilao, Batangas ang kanilang top recommended destination. As we all know, Batangas ang unang lugar na piniyagan ng buksan ng scuba diving tourism activities under general community quarantine. Tinarayo ang Anilao dahil sa ganda ng underwater paradise nito. Over 50 dive sites ang pwedeng pagpilian dito, teeming with marine life. Sikat din ang Anilao sa pagkakaroon ng diverse macro creatures o ang maliliit na nilalang sa ilalim ng dagat. Dahil dito, underwater photographer's haven din kung ituring ang Anilao. At isa nga sa mga underwater photographer na nahook sa ganda ng Anilao ay si Ram Yoro, an international multi-awarded Filipino underwater photographer. Ram Yoro is a pioneer and proponent of bonfire diving photography, a type of underwater photography method. Isa rin siyang technical diver who specialized in underwater cave and wreck photography. Hilig rin ni Ram na magsulat ng mga libro na nagpapakita ng ganda ng marine environment ng Pilipinas.
As an underwater photographer, how would you describe the beauty of Anilao?
Anilao, no, it's truly a special place. There's quite nothing like it anywhere else in the world. It's number one, has one of the highest, if not the highest, marine biodiversity. So in terms of coral species, fish species, isa siya sa mga pinakamarami sa mundo. And that's because Anilao shares the same waters with the Verde Island Passage, which is the center of the center of marine biodiversity according to the California Academy of Sciences. So scientifically proven yan. It is also very close to Manila, where most of the local divers are. So practically, it's, you know, you have, for Manila people at least, you have a paradise at your doorstep. With the new roads today, you can get here in less than 2 hours. Very, very easy, very convenient. And when you get here, okay, you enjoy the diversity, meaning the colors and the marine life. And you can do different kinds of dives here. So hindi ka magsasawa. You can do wide angle. You can do macro, which Anilao is very popular for. No? You can do a few wrecks. No? They don't have big wrecks, but may mga small wrecks like my helicopter wreck, my old barge wreck, and may mga scattered na mga jet skis and speedboat hulls. No? And for the technical divers, they even have caverns and caves here. There's one, Mapating Cave, that's popular in the diving community, in the technical diving community.
And that only means to say na yung Anilao yung favorite place nyo for underwater photography and diving.
Yes, I think it's obvious. That's why I decided to base myself here.
Gear up, buddies! Dahil ngayong araw ay ipapakita namin sa inyo ang ganda ng Anilao through underwater macro photography. For today's dive, sasamahan din tayo ng Sea Holic Dive Team to assist our underwater photography dive dito sa Pacifico Azul Houseway. Shore entry tayo ngayon mga buddies. Pacifico Azul House Reef is just a few meters away from our home for today's dive escapade. Banayad ang alon ng dagat, perfect for our shore dive. And in just a few minutes, ay narating na namin ang House Reef. Excited na excited ako during that dive kasi it's been almost a year na hindi ako nakakapag-dive and this time makakasama pa natin si Mr. Ram Yoro. Although nakapag-try na rin naman ako ng underwater photography before, pero nung 2013 pa yung huli ko siyang na-try dito rin sa Anilao and I'm really looking forward to doing it again here. Yung feature ng dive site, it's a sandy bottom with patches of hard and soft corals, which is very good for macro photography.
Habang naghahanap ng macro subjects si Ram, he started taking photos of the corals.
Normally, as you very well know, it's difficult, challenging to look for macro creatures to shoot because again, ang galing nila magtago. Mm-mm. And they're really tiny. So, before we get to that action, what I normally do is to practice shooting on corals just to get my distance right, my lighting right, my lenses right. No? Ang yung bonus dyan, when you take a macro shot of the corals, they're also beautiful enough.
Yeah.
So like kanina, ang ganda ng ano niya, details. So that's the beauty of macro photography because you bring out the best features of something that's not visible to the naked eye.
During that dive, ako rin yung naging spotter ni Ram and we encountered this unique species na first time ko lang din nakita. It's a rare flasher scorpionfish.
We went looking for macro stuff. No? While trying to look for the really, really small stuff, we came across this unique critter, the flasher scorpionfish. Anilao, there's so many scorpionfishes around. But not quite like the flasher scorpionfish. Medyo rare siya. Okay. So unlike the other scorpionfishes, this one, buo yung color niya. Usually solid white, solid red or green. And it's called flasher because it changes color based on where it is residing. So kapag green yung coral na, or flesh yung coral na tinatabihan niya, normally nagbe-blend in yan. Either nagbe-blend in or yung opposite. So like kanina, it was the opposite. Medyo dark yung rock, and then siya pure white.
Pure white.
So naging parang palamuti siya sa rock na. Mukha siyang bato pa rin.
Kaya nga.
And my spotter, of course, and you he had pretty good eyes to actually find that. I didn't even see it. No? So I got excited when we saw it. And then the thing with flasher scorpion fishes, like a lot of critters, napakaganda tingnan with your naked eye.
Actually.
Okay. But they're not photogenic in short. When you don't take care of your framing, of your lighting properly, it will turn out like a rock. Basically, that is what it wants to look like, no? A rock. So it's difficult to make it look beautiful, no? Or to make it pop out. So kanina, that was a challenge. So I decided on framing one of the special features of that animal, usually yung eyes niya. In photography, you always want to focus on the eyes, right?
Correct.
But this one, the eyes in particular has like different ornaments in it. No? Now with the naked eye, you can see it, but fortunately we had a macro lens. No? We could zoom in on it. No? So I took a bit of the mouth and the eyes to show that it's the head. No? And then the eye detail, ayun yung pinokus ko ng frame. Ang ganda. Beautiful, beautiful.
I also wanted to check it later.
Yes, let's see it later.
At saka binigyan mo rin ako ng chance to take a photo of it.
I hope you enjoyed it.
So syempre magkaiba yung level natin when it comes to that. But I'm very happy to be diving with you and to see that wonderful creature. And actually, first time ko rin siyang makita. Nakita ko siya sa ito. Kulay puti doon.
It's been a long time since I saw that animal also. Mm-hmm. So, pareho tayo medyo, no? Sabik makita siya.
took a photo of that flasher scorpion fish, may napadaan namang trigger fish. Nakakatuwa lang kasi nag-hover lang din siya sa tapat namin, and then nung nakakuha na si Ram ng photos, saka naman siya umalis. That dive was just a short dive dahil medyo malamig na rin yung tubig. Although it is just a shore diving, marami pa rin kami nakuna ng photos. We took a photo of this anemone fish, this cute and vibrant underwater tree worms, soft corals, and this group of racer fish. Anilao is truly a home to unique marine creatures. Kaya naman madalas dito nakukuha ng mga underwater photographer tulad ni Ram ang kanilang favorite underwater photograph. So, can you share us about your favorite photo, underwater photo taken here in Anilao?
There's actually so many, it's so hard to choose from. But if I were really to pick one, I will pick my photo of the yawning Rhinopias frondosa or lazy scorpion fish. The shot technically is not unique or special. It's just a portrait shot, no? With a black background, and it pops out because it's yawning. But because, you know, it stands for what Anilao is. The Rhinopias frondosa, for those who are not familiar, it's the holy grail of underwater photography. Mm-hmm. So for the longest time, inahanap-hanap yan kahit saang sulok na, no? Not only Anilao, Philippines, and even in the world. And we're lucky to have sighted it here, no? Sporadically, you know, but it has become more regular in the frequent years. So that photo is very special to me. It goes to show that Anilao has it all.
So can you tell us the story behind it? Yung
yes.
Paano mo siya kinunan?
Right.
Why it's so special aside from the things that you've said yes. before?
To go after the Rhinopias frondosa, no, it's a bit challenging. Because number one, master siya ng camouflage. It's called lazy or weedy kasi it's like a scorpion fish with a lot of tassels. And magaling siya maghanap ng habitat niya where it can blend perfectly. So it's so hard to find. And number two, it prefers deep waters, usually 25 meters or deeper. That one that I shot was at 33 meters. So you've been diving also,
yeah,
you know, at that depth,
yung
ano mo, yung bottom time is very, very short.
Yeah, correct.
So you have to be like very quick, no? Hanapin mo, and then after you lose time finding it, no? When you finally meet it, no? You only have like a minute or two to shoot it, and then medyo narked ka pa, so dapat mabilis. It was an effort, in short, to look for it, no? I was with a Malaysian friend who flew over to the Philippines just to look for that.
Oh.
So ganun siya ka special. And of course, because he was the visitor, I had to wait. So siya muna, he took his sweet time, and I didn't want to bother him because he's enjoying himself so much. Shoot. I was already like low on air, and my decompression time was already like running out. So while waiting, I just tried to prepare for the shot. No? Fix my strobes, my lighting and everything, picked a position and decided on the framing. The moment he stepped back, as in literally I just went in and just did three shots. Pak, that was it. Because my deco time was already up. No? And then I had to leave. No? And I just hope that I got it right. I didn't even have time to check it.
Yes. So that's how you
achieved that shot. Diyos, so medyo maayos siya. It could have been better, but it was good enough given the circumstances.
Underwater photographer, what is the positive and negative impacts na nangyari during the lockdown?
The ocean, because of the lockdown, basically it was untouched, so to speak. So walang nakakapasok dito. And it's the natural habitat of fish and the critters that we know. And just like anything else, no, even like in the mountains, you have the forests and the plants and the trees. No, if you leave them, they normally tend to grow some more, no, populate the place and grow in numbers. And this is what we've noticed here in Anilao. Especially, particularly in red-toothed trigger fish. They, if you go out on a boat, go to the open sea dive sites, there's just thousands of them, literally thousands of them. And then you must schooling fishes also. But with regards to the macro stuff, no, I haven't observed any difference yet. The same guys are still out. No? Their volume is still the same. No? I'm just speculating. I'm not a marine bio, but based on observation, I think because of the increase of in numbers of these schooling fishes, mga reef fishes, na kocontrol ng population ng mga macro critters on the bottom, because yun yung pagkain nila. Mm-hmm. So yun yung, that's how nature balances
yun
itself out.
Yung medyo pumonte. Bukod sa mga positibong epekto ng lockdown, may mga ibinalita rin sa atin ang Anilao Tourism Office tungkol sa mga kaabang-abang na tourism activities dito sa Anilao.
Meron din kaming mga ibang mga binabalak kagaya ng nalalapit na pagbabalik ng Anilao Underwater Photo Shootout. Ito yung prestigious na 10 na international macro photography. Ito ay pinahintulutan na, actually binasbasan na ng ating secretary Bernadette Puyat. Ina-anticipate natin na matutuloy ito bandang Mayo. Ang binabalak dito ay siguro yung tinatawag nating bubble tourism. Magkakaroon tayo ng partner country na mga identified natin na ligtas, at yung mga bisita nila airport to Anilao kaagad. So secured talaga at saka properly coordinated yung kanilang mga biyahe at yung kanilang mga accommodations ay sa ating mga accredited na TOT resorts pa talaga.
Sinisiguro naman ng local government unit of Mabini ang safe travel experience ng mga bibisitang turista.
We are very closely coordinating with the Department of Tourism. Lahat ng mga guidelines na binabato nila sa amin ay mariin naming ipinapasa sa ating mga accredited dive resort. Sa ngayon, lahat naman ito ay nasusunod. Andyan yung pagpapatupad natin ng proper health protocols, kagaya itong paglalagay ng mga tamang signages, floor markers, pag-i-implement ng mga thermal scanning sa check-in, contact tracing. Kailangan meron silang contact tracing na manual, yung health declaration form at saka sa logbook, sapat na social distancing, especially kung hindi magkakakilala.
So choose an accredited authorized to operate dive resorts here in Anilao, mga kasangbahay, to make sure you'll have an enjoyable and relaxing escapade, gaya ng na-experience namin dito with Pacifico Azul Dive Resort. During our dive escapade, mas nagkaroon kami ng pagkakataong makilala pa si Ramiro. Dito, mas nakita namin kung paano niya nagamit ang kanyang passion for underwater photography to help for marine conservation.
Kailan ka nag-umpisang mag-scuba dive?
I started scuba diving around 2006. Before that, no, I got the invitation to take up scuba many times, but I declined. Finally, when I decided to take on the invitation to get certified, it totally changed everything for me. No, it's a hobby in the beginning, and then the next thing you know, like most divers here, no, will tell you open water ka sa umpisa, and then the next thing you know, dive master ka na, para ang bilis ng progression. First dive sa pool pa lang, no, yung taking a sip from the regulator, compressed air. it sounds funny now or nothing to us, but it was a totally new sensation for me. So that one just already got me already. So excited na ako. And then paglubog ng ulo mo, and then you can see clearly breathing. It was totally a mind-blowing experience for me sa pool pa lang. When we went to the ocean, it was even more exciting kasi mas maraming kulay, mas maraming moving parts. The term, sensory overload na. Yung first diving experience ko, and I remember the highlight there was we saw a lionfish. No? To me at the time, it was the most beautiful animal on earth anywhere. Mm-hmm. And then as I kept diving, I realized it's very common in the sea.
So that the first time you get excited, wow, lionfish.
Lionfish.
It's so pretty.
You kept telling people, sino makita mo? Do you know there's this animal called lionfish? Ganito. And then a few weeks later, I realized mo, parang walang natutuwa sa lionfish story. Ano pala yan? Very common.
Dahil sa kanyang underwater adventures and burning desire for his passion, nagdesisyon si Ram na iwan ang kanyang corporate career at maging full-time scuba instructors and underwater photographer.
Maybe I can switch careers and give up my 8-to-5 job and do this full-time and at the same time earn a decent living. 2010, when I became a pro, that's also when I started becoming more serious with the photography. Because I was doing it full-time, when I was not teaching, dami mo oras and you're at the ocean. Mm-hmm. So what do? You yank a buddy, dive, and then photo.
Hindi lang sa pamamagitan ng underwater photography na ipakikita ni Ram ang ganda ng karagatan. Ginamit niya rin ang kanyang talento sa pagsusulat to share more information and his dive experiences.
Even from way back high school, I really liked to write creative writing. It was just that I never had the forum or opportunity to take it seriously. Now when I was doing photography, it came hand in hand. Some people just like phrase or a few liner. Me, I like to tell the story, to describe what this animal is or what it is doing or ano yung habitat niya, trivia. First off, it was me, Andrew Marriott, and this is like our first project together. It was our pet project, meaning hindi siya commercial yung intent talaga. We just wanted to come up with a proper guidebook. No? And we decided the way to go about it is to catalog all the dive sites in the area. Just so you know, also we have another book. Sinundan namin yon after the success of the book. We followed it up with this book. It's called Legends Beneath the Waves, Philippines. These are all about different wreck destinations. We decided to come up with one about Philippines, and primarily about the wrecks in Subic and Coron. So this book is available in all of the dive shops in Manila. I know that from my last update, it's already about to go out of stock. Paubos na.
Wow.
So if you want to grab, please check the dive shop closest to you. Might have some pa.
Actually, na-impressed ako dun sa mga kuha. Kasi sobrang ang gaganda ng mga shots. Ipinapakita ko siya sa aming mga bisita minsan. Kung halimbawa gusto nilang malaman yung mga dive sites na mas in-depth kung ano ba yung background, ano yung istorya dito, ano yung mga pwedeng makita doon. So, yun, napakalaking tulong para sa mga bisita at lalong-lalo na sa mga interesadong mga divers.
Pero bukod sa ganda ng dagat, nakita rin ni Ram ang ibang mukha ng kalagayan ng karagatan.
So, in your career naman, ano yung pinaka-frustrating scene na na-observe mo underwater?
There have been quite a few. There was one time I remember not here in Anilao, in another location, also in the Philippines, may malapad na mga ghost nets that were left by big commercial fishing vessels. They weren't supposed to be there. They did illegal fishing. And then the next thing we know is the reef was already like suffocating. That was heartbreaking to see that. And then there was also another time, I was diving in an area, South Luzon, and that area was known for dynamite fishing. And then while we were diving, we could hear like the explosion sometimes. A few minutes later, nadaanan namin isang area, nagkalat yung mga patay na isda. So ito, you could tell it's fresh pa kasi number one, we heard the sound, and then number two, we saw all the fish like sprawling on the floor in a patay, parang It was a zombie, an apocalyptic na scene. It was very depressing. And we didn't even finish the dive. We just decided we come out also for safety purposes. Maybe the guy throwing it just won't see us. And then we were just so outright depressed, downright depressed.
Why do you want to keep on taking photos?
I want to keep sharing the beauty of the ocean to others because it's very rewarding to share to people, and you see the change in them that they begin to care for the ocean. Sometimes we think that the ocean is inanimate, it's not alive, it's just there, it's like ornamental lang. No, it's from the corals to the fish, it's so alive. And when they see it's alive, and when they see their beauty, their uniqueness, stuff that we don't see here on land, and then the effect is you see them getting inspired to want to care for it. So that's why I want to keep writing, and I want to keep taking photos and just keep sharing and sharing and sharing and sharing. I'll never get tired, I think. As an underwater photographer, I guess I can speak for my colleagues. You feel this responsibility a bit, that you are a steward of the ocean. You're not the owner, you're just a visitor, but you are the only link, one of the few links that can connect the people from here on the surface to underwater through your photos. And it's kind of like a battle because, all over the world, not only the Philippines, there's illegal fishing, there's dynamite fishing, cyanide, and now the big problem is trash. We don't take care of our trash, the coastal communities. We're not properly educated about disposal. We don't we indiscriminately let them float through the ocean, and it's affecting what's out there now. So when you see that and you know that's happening all over, the more you want to take photos, the more you want to write about it, to let them know na that's kind of like your information campaign.
Ang mga kuhang larawan ni Ramioro ay patunay na may natatanging ganda at buhay sa ilalim ng dagat. At bilang isang underwater photographer, ang mga lenteng ito ay naging sandata ni Ram upang maging ambag niya sa advokasiyang pangalagaan ang karagatan.
This is your diving buddy, The Dive! The Dive!